Hey, so five ways to improve your style with underrated sneakers. So why should you care about underrated sneakers? Well, a lot of times there are really great sneakers that are simply overlooked, and that can be for a lot of reasons, whether it's because a sneaker really caters to kind of a niche audience, or the sneaker has a really subtle design or subtle colorway, or simply because people just don't know about this sneaker or brand. And some of the best parts of underrated sneakers are just that they're a lot easier to purchase for retail or even on sale. And underrated sneakers really help play into more low-key fashion where you're doing a lot less trend following, the style is more individualized. In a way, it can help you be ahead of the style trend or the style curve. Not that that really matters. But with that out of the way, let's get into it. The first sneaker, the Cold Wall Air Max Plus. So I think that these sneakers are overlooked because the collab is basically just swapping the materials on the upper. If you think about it, it's actually a really great way to make a great sneaker. The Air Max Pluses are really technical, but the leather makes it really refined. So what you get is this nice combination of this technical silhouette along with this refined look of the leather upper. And there are just so many ways to style the sneaker, especially in black, and they're actually really comfortable. So the fit with this one, up top, we have this beautiful Stussy gradient Sherpa fleece. At the bottoms, we have this JW Anderson wide fit wash black denim. And overall, it's just a nice pop of color from one of my favorite Sherpa fleeces. We have this black base from the wash denim and also the black sneakers. And it's just a really easy way to style color. So my tip for this sneaker and this fit, all black leather runners can create a really easy base for you to style louder or more colorful or interesting pieces up top. So the next pair of sneakers, the Elleeks Air Force Ones. So Air Force Ones, one of the most popular sneakers of all time. It's one of the most classic silhouettes. And because of those reasons, I feel like this collab was just completely overlooked. This collab basically only changes a few aspects of the sneaker itself. Essentially, there's no mudguard that's been removed. The leather has been upgraded a little bit, and there's silver detailing on the side of the sneaker. But that's pretty much it. So it's a really subtle collaboration, but I think this collab just makes the classic Air Force Ones a little bit better, especially the black colorway. So black Air Force Ones usually have a bad rap, but if you're able to get past that, these black Air Forces, because they're elevated by the collaboration, are a really great addition to your wardrobe. Because you'll see that black Air Forces are actually a really versatile sneaker to have within your collection. So the fit here up top, we have a black leather jacket from Mutimer, a small Australian brand. And the bottoms here, we just have some smart pants from Uniqlo. And for this fit overall, it's a big statement in the leather jacket. The sneakers match that refined look of the leather jacket without being too overpowering in terms of style. And overall, I think it's just an easy way to style a leather jacket. I think the leather jacket is a big statement that can be really hard to style, and I think typically leads people to wear boots or more formal leather shoes. But I feel like having this refined black Air Force One really helps to tone down that outfit overall. It's something that only a sneaker could provide. So my tip for this one, a nice pair of black Air Forces can really help replace boots or more formal leather shoes and help create a more toned down fit for an overall cleaner aesthetic. Next underrated sneaker, the Nike Dunk Highs. So this is the chunkier, less beloved silhouette of the Nike Dunks. It's really just overlooked because of the bulkier design from the higher cut of the sneaker. I actually think that's one of the good things about the Dunk Highs. I think that because of that bulkier silhouette, it's actually easier to kind of wear these with wider fitting pants. Another benefit, Dunk Highs are cheaper across the board just because of that lower demand from the market. For Dunk Highs, classic colorways are more readily available and collabs aren't as hyped as something like a Dunk Low. And honestly, Dunk Highs give you pretty much the same style, especially when you're wearing wider fitting pants. So maybe the one downside of the Dunk Highs for me is that with shorts, styling these is a different story where I probably wouldn't wear the Dunk Highs with shorts, but would definitely wear the Dunk Lows with shorts. But the fit I have here, we have a gray hoodie from Hours up top in a nice oversized fit. We have one of my wardrobe essentials. These are some pleated sweatpants from Uniqlo U. And to top it all off, we have our quilted oversized shoulder bag from COS in cobalt blue. And the sneakers, UNC Dunk Highs. This is just a very simple, cozy athleisure fit. The Dunk Highs, again, make it easy to style wider pants. And even though these sweats are more of a straight fit, fit, they still sit nicely on top of the sneakers compared to something like a low-cut sneaker. And overall, I think the classic design of the sneakers just goes really well with the simple styling of this fit. So, 2-for-1 tip here. For a higher cut or bulkier sneakers, you can style these with wider pants that sit nicely over the top of the silhouette. And for classic silhouettes like the Dunks or the Jordan 1s, go with a simpler fit that pairs nicely with kind of the simpler design of these silhouettes. The next sneaker, Salomon XT4s. These are the older, often more overlooked model of the Salomon XT6s. But to me, XT4s are just as comfortable and they have a really similar style to the XT6s. XT4s, I feel like, just have a lot more creative expression within the colorways that Salomon releases. XT4s are still perfect for gorpcore when you're trying to style more technical pieces. XT4s are just a little bit more low key, and I feel like they deserve just as much respect as the XT6s. So the fit here, we have some olive hiking pants from Amazon. Up top, we have a nice fitting long sleeve from Uniqlo U. And the piece that ties this fit all together, we have the Pas Normal and Salomon 20 liter pack. And overall, I think this fit is just heavy into urban outdoors slash urban cycling, urban running. It's not quite gorpcore, but still maintains a lot of the functionality and the technical details of something like a gorpcore fit. So the technical details of the pants match the technical design of the shoes. And the backpack is, again, that perfect match of the same styling. There's lots of utility in the design of the pants, the design and colorway of the backpack. So the tip for this sneaker and this outfit, technical pieces go together. Think utility features, whether that's waterproofing, extra storage, durable slash breathable materials, hidden functions like vents or having convertible pants. Technical or functional pieces go really well together. In the last sneaker, we have the District Vision New Balance Fresh Foam More Trail V3s. That's quite a mouthful, but I think this is a really overlooked collaboration just because this is a really niche sneaker model from New Balance. It's a really chunky trail runner, but I think that District Vision did such a great job bringing a clean aesthetic to something as rugged as the Fresh Foam More Trails. Again, it's a chunky trail runner. These actually have really great performance in terms of running, but yeah, overall, it's just a really extremely niche sneaker silhouette. But I think this is just a really beautiful collaboration sneaker that brings together lifestyle and also performance. And this collab is mainly overlooked just because it is a niche silhouette with a niche brand collaborating with New Balance. But I really feel like these are really beautifully designed. But for the fit, on the bottoms, we have some Stussy Realtree Camo Wide Fit Denim. These are their big old jeans. Up top, we have this really nice black knit from a creator's brand called Ordinary Practice, formerly known as Bummer by Drew. And for the bag that ties together this fit, we have the Suno bag from Hours. In my eyes, I think this is the most stylish fit out of this video. And it's just a really easy way to style really loud pants like these. Overall, just an easy way to style Realtree camo. I think the knit is a really nice soft texture that blends well with the overall durability and workwear aesthetic of the camo pants, and I think is really reflective in the design of this collaboration sneaker as well, where you have the softness of the cream colored mesh upper paired with that rugged trail running outsole of the Fresh Foam More Trails. So the fit overall, it's comfortable up top, but also has more rugged elements in the Suno bag and also the denim. And you see the same thing on the sneakers, with the mesh being comfortable up top, and then the more rugged midsole and outsole of the Fresh Foam More Trails. And the tip for styling Realtree camo, I think, is to tone down your other pieces while also trying to incorporate more workwear elements to create that more rugged and cohesive styling of the fit. So hey, if you like this video, please give it a like, drop a comment, hit the bell, subscribe. And if you're looking for more style inspiration and how to style some of the most trending sneakers, check out this video here. So thanks so much for watching. I'll see you in the next one.